Hello, my name is Elsa Mohino. I'm Associate Professor at the Physics of the Earth and Astrophysics Department of the University Complutense of Madrid. In this video, we will discuss what a climate model is. In a nutshell, a climate model is a highly complex computer program that simulates the climate system. The most comprehensive ones are called Earth system models and take into account climate-relevant systems as the atmosphere, ocean, cryosphere, land, biosphere, and processes like the carbon cycle. At the core is a general circulation model that represents the processes that take place in the atmosphere and ocean, as well as their interactions. To do so, they rely on a knowledge on fluid mechanics and thermodynamics that have been developed since the 18th century and that are framed in mathematical formulations. These formulations are translated into computer programs that numerically approximate the evolution of climate-relevant variables using high-performance computers. The atmosphere and ocean are partitioned in what are called grid cells, which are three-dimensional boxes in which the changes in variables like wind speed, temperature, pressure, density, or moisture are calculated. The smaller the grid cells, the more processes that can be explicitly simulated. For those processes too small or not well understood, but which are nonetheless relevant and have a measurable impact, the models use physical or statistical approximations that are called parameterizations, as they typically depend on one or several parameters. There are many such processes like cloud microphysics, radiation, turbulence, or exchanges with the surface, to name a few. To run, models need two main inputs. On the one hand, as the climate model's main task is to simulate the evolution of climate variables, they need a starting point. This is a description of the climate system, all variables in all grid cells at the initial time. On the other hand, the climate system is not isolated. For instance, it receives the sun's energy, which might change slightly through the solar cycle. Moreover, a current climate is subjected to variable radiative forcing coming from greenhouse gases and aerosols. All in all, the models need information on such changes. This is what we call a boundary condition. Climate models can simulate today's climate, provided with the current external forcing. In a similar fashion, they can simulate changes in the climate system since the Industrial Revolution, using our best estimates of the changes in these forcings. Models can also be used to simulate the future evolution of the climate system if they are provided with future changes in the forcing, namely, changes in the emissions or concentrations, depending on the model, of greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide, methane, or nitrous oxide, and other species that also play a role in the radiative transfer properties of the atmosphere, like black carbon or sulfur dioxide. However, how do we predict what the evolution of these gases and other species will be like? Such evolution will heavily depend on many choices that us as humans will make. For instance, how will technology, economy, lifestyle, or policy change? How many of us will we be? How much energy will we consume? Unfortunately, we cannot predict such changes. But this does not mean there is nothing we can do, because we can imagine possible futures and, based on them, evaluate what the climate would look like. And this is precisely what scenarios are about, which is the topic of our next video on climate scenarios. Thank you for watching.